the show tonight. That's it. Thank you very much. Have a good night. Thank you, guys. It's such a pleasure to have all of you here for What a Drag 2016. Yeah. Raising funds for equal love, marriage equality. Hell yeah! Yeah! Oh, come on. You can do better than that. Show me love, Melbourne! Do I look pretty tonight?
Yeah!
Do you like it, my dress, Jean-Paul Gaultier? Hair by Trent Ashley?
Yeah!
And tits by Clark Rubber. Enough of the talking already, guys. We got a show to get it going and we're going to get you entertained tonight. So ladies and gentlemen, all the way from New Zealand, singing live for you, give it up for the Miss and gorgeous Bumbalove!
Hit it, Robbie.
For the last 10 years, my full-time employment has been lip-syncing,
but I'm a trained singer, dancer, actor, and I just thought, you know what, I've been working lip syncing to other people's music for a long time. Tonight is quite special. I'm married legally in my own country, and I just really think that it's time that if I could touch someone who could talk to someone else, a member of parliament, I do a lot of work in that area myself, but if I could touch someone else to make them head into motion to help support gay marriage in Australia, then I'll use my own voice and I'll be me, and that's why I chose to sing.
Really nice philosophy that you have there, and I really liked the way that you, I suppose, in our lingo, had a little dig at the Australian government for not allowing same-sex marriage. You're a married man from New Zealand. What's really changed in New Zealand for the gay community since marriage was legalised?
We've got quite a big hurdle when it comes to people living who have committed a crime and have been in jail. Especially if they're transgender, so they, you know, a transgender woman could get put into a cell with a male, so that there is conflict in that. So in New Zealand we are working very much so with our cisgender and transgender community to, you know, get some rights put in there. It is hard for the justice system to do that in New Zealand because men, women, thousands of dollars to make prisons, but the conversation has been very robust, angry, rioting. However, through that comes other discussions. So it's been about a good 18 months, I would say.
Yeah, a long process. But New Zealand just leads the way for it. It's such a small country, the first to give women the vote, amongst the first to allow same-sex marriage. What do you think New Zealand's going to be first at next?
I would say it would be about law change for transgender and cisgender people. Something that a lot of people probably don't know is I've run Auckland's Pride Parade, which is a mini version of Mardi Gras in New Zealand for the last 2 years. So they are very committed at working with the community, and if there's something going wrong, they'll find, and this is what's going on in New Zealand at the moment.
Well, thank you very much for tonight. Thank you very much for talking to us, and every success with your future endeavours. And I must ask, what did you actually say in your performance when you were talking music and Maori?
It was Maori. Being that I was opening act, I know that our hostess, she is also from New Zealand, so it's important for me to acknowledge whenever we have something opening, we acknowledge the house that we're in and the land that we are on.
Beautiful.
So that's what I was doing in my own language.
Beautiful, thank you. Can we hear it one more time?
Ngā mihi ki a koutou ki te whenua me takatāpui here. So thank you to this house and to our rainbow community here in Melbourne.
Beautiful, thank you. Thank you so much.